times. Come on. Oyou, own your own universe. Join us to the Community Arts Center Project. One day we're gonna have a building. It's a moody Sunday. Everybody gathered round having some fun. Hey, hey, it's a moody Sunday. Mondays are coming on the run.
Land on the dust off my old brandy glasses. Pour myself a stiff cocktail right after the show. Put on some old southern blues. Gonna dance around in my shoes.
Oyou work for the past 10 years has been the volunteers. So this tune here is, it's a tune that embodies friendship, showing up, being present, and taking the opportunity to tell those that are close to us that we love them. So here it goes. It's called Worthy. Gone wrong, loves chicken chimichangas and old country songs. She used to teach high school, now she just drives around in her old Chevy size stuff. She picks me up when I'm down. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm alright. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm I'm all right, yeah. play cards, we drink wine and share dreams. It took a long time to grow old friends like mine that circle the wagons when I need peace of mind. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm all right. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm all right. I'm all right. We make the colors inside the wheel. The labyrinth we walk reminds us what's real. So those that we love will find us in the stars. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm all right. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm all right. Make me worthy of the love of my friends, 'cause when I'm with them, I'm all right.
Cool ending.
Oh my, oh you, oh no universe!
What do y'all think about our music camp?
I love the soil of the Blackland Prairies, where it meets the West Texas hills. I thank the people who grew the cotton and ginned it right here in the mills. To the loving and living and dreaming of those who lived on this land, let me be like them in spirit and strength and give back the things that I can. Here off the highway runs a river road byway between Austin and Old San Antonio. A place with a history, nature's sweet mystery, a place that I call my own. Looking down in the depths of the clear, cold river, life gets better each day. Big cities don't thrill me with their glamour and glitter. San Marcos is where I will stay.
One of the first official groups of the OYOU was the Epilepsy Support Group. And that's because I was diagnosed with epilepsy around 1990, and it has ran parallel to my entire career as a performing singer-songwriter. And with epilepsy comes a lot of other issues: medication, finances, doctors, you name it. And it's not something that I could handle by myself. And luckily, I met other people that have what I have And they became friends, and we formed a support group. And two of the people that really helped lay the grassroots for not only the epilepsy support group, but for what would soon become the OIOU, was Mark and Allison Genfand. Their son McCoy has epilepsy, and we all spoke the same language, the language of doctors, medical bills, testing, medication changes, and dealing with generic medications and how they can vary up to 30%. When you have a neurological disability, when your medication can vary 30% month by month, you need to know that, because a lot of times that's when the breakthrough seizures happen. And so these meetings that we had helped everyone in the meetings get better, because there's strength in numbers. And that philosophy of strength in numbers spoke to me, and it spoke to Lloyd Maines and also Mike Lawrence, who would later become a key part of our board of directors for this nonprofit. And so this is this tune that I'm about to play for you. It's called Einstein's Brain, and it's about how when your brain doesn't exactly work like everybody else, how you manage to rise above that and carve out a life in spite of your challenges. If I had Picasso's hands, oh, the world I'd draw. If I had Einstein's brain, oh, the good I'd do. It's like trying to sail when you're nowhere near the sea. Something's so easily, not for me. Now my chances have come and gone. I've said hello and said so long. I missed a boat and caught a train. My turn time and again. It's like trying to say you're nowhere near the sea. Some things come so easily. Not for me. I lately I've been thinking I need to rest a while. You can go on chasing down the moon. I'm no Mickey Mantle, but I got his smile. I cry till I laugh, that's what I do. Yeah, yeah. On the dance floor, I'm no Fred Astaire. I got two left feet. Without grace, I still pray. Though the answers are like years away, it's like trying to sail when you're nowhere near the sea. Some things come so easily. Hands. Oh, the world I good idea. That's what I do. I do good for you. Do a little bit better now. That's what I do. Just thought I'd give you a quick shout out and let you know the great things I've come across at the Oyou, which is ownyourownuniverse.org. It's a great nonprofit organization, and it is full of amazing people and things to do for all kinds of people across the board. There is no boundaries. They're great folks. They're really reassuring, and any venue you want to
expand in. They'll give you the confidence and mentor you through music or poetry, anything that's got to do with the arts, songwriting classes. I've done a lot of amazing things and learned a lot of great stuff from the folks that are hosting these classes. Guitar group with the girls. There's a girls guitar group that meets, and it is so much fun to sit in a room full of great women playing guitar. There's no bias there. There's everybody is on an open mind, friendship basis. They're accepting and understanding. They've helped me through grief and helped me get back into songwriting. I really, really cannot understate how much I appreciate them. The folks there, not only are they physically and mentally challenging, it is inspiring and fun. So, peace out. This is Diane Swag, or Deezy.
Let it be, let it be.
I've got to say one thing. I have been at a writer's block for the past 2 years. I've got two novels that have sat on my desktop and haven't touched them. They've gathered dust. When I came out here to OYOU 2 weekends ago, DC Bloom and the rest of the folks here, Terri, everybody, they found a key that unlocked that writer's block. And now I haven't been able to stop. It gave me the courage to put that first word down on the second chapter, and it's been nonstop ever since. So, let me tell you, don't put it on the back shelf anymore. Just get out there and do it. Write down that first word. You'll love it.
my name is Carol, and I've been part of the OYOU since 2016, when I went to my very first OYOU women's retreat. And I didn't really know what to expect. I knew a few people that were in the group, and I love to play music, and I was hoping that it would be something I could play music with other people and just meet some other people that were interested in the arts and music. And I did at this retreat, and it was that and more. I didn't expect to make the friends that I've made through this, and I honestly didn't expect to fit in the first retreat, and I was so wrong. I was afraid of being judged. I was afraid of not being able to play well enough, and none of that was true. We got there, and it was very supportive. I was made to feel welcome immediately, and the group drew me in. I've kept going back, and I've gone to the retreats every year, and I've met more women through the retreats. And along the way, we started a women's song circle that meets once a month at OYOU in Martindale, and it has been life-changing for me. It's given me a lot more confidence in being able to play with other musicians, and just and the support from this group is just so wonderful. It doesn't matter if you can play guitar, if you can play keyboard, you can play whatever, you can sing. If you don't want to sing, you don't play an instrument, you just like music, you show up and you ask for somebody else to lead it, and then you just join in, and it's a group effort, and everyone's made to feel welcome. Everyone's supported, no one's judged on their ability or lack of ability, and I don't feel like I'm performing. I'm not having to prepare and be terrified I'm gonna fail. No, it's a very supportive environment. I can try original songs if I want to. I can bring new music. I can play some of the music that we have existing in our binders. We've started collecting different chord sheets on different songs, and each month we get together and each person takes a turn, goes around the circle. If you don't want to take a turn, you don't have to. You can ask someone else to take your turn. It's very laid back. It's very supportive. There are people who come and read poetry if they don't want to sing, and they have a poem. Everything is accepted pretty much for this. And just the support is so important.
If I had a daughter, I'd tell her that the first breath of life is the easiest. From then on, it takes years of practice. Because if you know how to keep air in your lungs, then you'll survive when fate tackles you, rubs your face in the astroturf, and grinds its cleats into your back. I'd tell her that it's better to be out there on the field of life, taking hits and making touchdowns, than bitching about the game in the bleachers. If I had a daughter, I teach her how to face life in its peaks and valleys with grit, modesty, hope, compassion, and love. I'd want her to accept herself. I'd want her to watch the stars instead of her weight. Love her body, feed her soul, dance with her curves, see those blue veins as a masterpiece, howl at the moon instead of her hair, and to live inside out. If I had a daughter, I'd teach her to hold her head high and strut through this world as a more than instead of a less than. She'd trust her voice, speak her mind, and seek the truth. 'Cause if it talks like a duck and walks like a duck, then yes, it might be a skunk. If I had a daughter, she'd know that gay or straight, pinstriped or polka-dotted, tie-dyed or solid, straight-laced or bent, she'd have my acceptance and blessing in regards to whomever she gave her heart to. If I had a daughter, I'd give her a compass, so if she was lost, she could find her way back to reality. And when her soul hit the low notes and her heart was a kick drum, I'd teach her how to turn it into song. If I had a If I had a daughter, I'd want her to be willing to venture into the great unknown. But I'd make sure she had the blueprints to build her own universe. If I had a daughter, I would carry her with me in every breath of every moment. I would wake with her name on my lips and go to bed with her dreams in my heart. If I had a daughter. If I had a daughter.
Sisterhood, it's camaraderie, it's an education about yourself. You learn things that you never knew about yourself because you're seeing yourself through other people's eyes and you're finding out that you have a lot more power and strength than you ever knew.
Lots of fundraisers over the years, and this past year we were finally able to have an event that was not a fundraiser. It started out that way, though. It was called Playing for Good, and it was a fundraiser for the OYOU to put money in the bank, and we did that in 2015 2016. Then it moved to Quail Creek Country Club, which was fantastic. Thank you so much, Don and Barb Harrelson, for helping us with at Quail Creek Country Club. And so we hosted it there and saved all that money. And then I always had this dream of being able to host an event that didn't have a ticket price. It was just a free music, community-wide music festival. And that finally happened this year. And the city of Martindale got together, and their city council gave us a grant, and we were able to book the performers, and it helped underwrite the costs of a free music festival. Why a free music festival? Here's why. Because when you have a free music festival, it makes it to where there's not a ticket price. It makes it open up to families that are on fixed income or retired people that are on a fixed income, and anyone can come out and enjoy the music. And that's part of our mission statement, which is to where anyone, regardless of income or ability or disability, can come out and enjoy music. And So when we had Tammy Fest this past October, it was amazing because I got to see the entire city of Martindale turn out, and then plus folks that were from out of town, and everyone was dancing. And the city and the tourism department of Martindale made that happen. And we're just a small rural town. So this is called Come Tomorrow. And to me, it's a great way to embody that life will bring hardship and life will bring change. But how you react to both shows who and what you are as a person. And I can say that that the folks that have risen up to help the OIOU become what it has become, they've shown me how I can rise as well and meet expectations and surpass my own preconceived abilities to what I myself can do. And that goes right back into the mission statement of the OIOU. So here it goes. This is called Come Tomorrow. Like a skipping stone, came to a stop, called it home, lay down, move on, come tomorrow. Turn nothing into something, to rise from dirt, it's an uphill battle just to prove our worth. Lay down, move on, come tomorrow. You sing about forgiveness if you can forgive. Every fall in the dark, you know how to live. Lay down, move on, come tomorrow. All is to time, all at a cost, pearls on string. Fence lines to cross is catching the light before it's lost. Come tomorrow. Green is the field, gold is the sun, and white is the cotton I dry my tears on when I lay down and move on. Come tomorrow. We got the sun on our skin. We're back on the road. We feel good again. Paid back every time that we owed. You gotta plant what you like to come up from below the sorrow. And you sing about forgiveness if you can forgive. If we fall in the dark,